Hi, today introduction video for the teardown of this. We have here the famous EM25 German made military radio from the late 60s and 70s. So this version is the receiver only version, the EM25. You can find the complete version with a sender in German. Or emitter the SEM25. Actually, I had one in the early 2000 and I did sell it around 2005. So the difference physical is the emitter version is one third larger and one third larger base plate with power supply. The control box will be the same. So this is already not far from 20 kilos. So, obviously, the emitter version will be even heavier and bulkier. They are best sellers on eBay. You can find these devices everywhere, in particular in eBay Germany, at very random prices. Working emitter set in good condition is usually around 200 or 300 euros. But with a little bit of luck and patience, you can actually get much better prices. I got this one for 60 euros with domestic shipping, which was not too bad. There is one other very famous accessory, the antenna tuner box. So these things are all around on eBay. Usually around 20 euros you can get one. In very random conditions. I do not know how many of them were made, but really, they are overflowing, still overflowing on eBay. And number of them available. A lot more than the radios themselves. So there is already a teardown of this on my channel. And thanks to another YouTuber, I got the pinout to the radio, which is actually quite simple. And I will be able to demonstrate the functionality of this antenna tuner. Normally, there would be a BNC cable between the antenna tuner and the radio, but I just found I have no BNC to BNC cable. I do not deal a lot with radio stuff usually, and I have none of them. But it is not a big deal because I believe there is nothing to receive on the frequencies. It will cover. So which frequencies do we have? Maximum is 69.95 MHz. And it will go down to, I believe, in the 26 range MHz. Okay. So power supply for this thing is 24, 27 volts, something like this. I have here at the back. A very safe and secure 27 volts power supply, 24, and it will work just fine. You find on the web all the information about the schematics, pinouts, and everything you need. And actually, there is something fun because I did receive a bunch of documentation with this radio by the seller. It came in a big folder like this with all printouts from all the websites from 2000 era. So the schematics, the pinouts, everything from various websites. The kpjung.de, which is now greenradio.de. You should check this web one, very interesting. And guess what? The guy had actually printouts from my own website I made in early 2000 with some photos of my previous set I had. So really quite fun to receive from a guy printouts from a website you did yourself. And it has all the schematics, but you can find them online quite easily. So everything you need to know is available. So it was really, really fun when I found that the guy sent to me my own website. Okay, so now today I will demonstrate power on. We will have a walk around and maybe I will separate the modules, but given how tedious and complicated this teardown will be, it will be a multi-part video. Will be one part for this control box, one part for the power supply, I believe, and the back main box here will be several parts because it is full of various modules and things. Okay. So all the controls are located here. There is a function switch here between you can do relay function, radio relay functions. There is a transmit button, but it is not enabled because here we have a receiver only, volume control, the main frequency selector. This must be a transmit on light, I believe, or just power on, okay. The channel selector, because you can either dial manually or program a channel. With the weird thing you have here, quite tedious to use. I will show it better in the video for the teardown of this box, which will be pretty quick because actually you cannot take a lot of part in this thing without going in a no way back thing. The main function switch here with power off, receive, and powerful or small sending power, transmitting power. I am speaking German, by the way. Here we have an interesting stamp. I believe it is from the French army. Everything have a label like this with NATO stock number, the name of the module, serial number, and other informations. But first, power on. So, and you have two main cables here between the base unit and the back box, and one between this unit and the control box. Normally there is a cable special for the antenna tuner, of course, and there are a number of other accessories available for this radio. I will link some of the websites that describe the whole setup. But now we will try a power on, and at the same time we will be able to see this box working. It is quite fun and it makes really nice noises. So power on. First you will dial and then you will have this is squelch, I believe. Yes. And it will do the box here react because I believe we have nothing to listen on the frequencies. I did try already and really there is nothing to be received, but you get the ID. So for now I will disconnect the speaker because really it is annoying. Okay, this is the regular how is it called already? U77U plug. For military radios, very common. You find the pinout and everything on the web. So here I am dialed manually. I will show you now this box reacting, the antenna tuner box. So there is already a teardown on this on my channel, and the other one I will link. But it is quite fun to see how it works. We have a number of screws to adjust inductor and capacitor here for each frequency, so you will adjust the screws, it will adjust the offset of the parts, and they will tune like this. And there are some sensors here, well, cams or something like this, that will go out of the way when it is turning, because if not, if you have a big gap between two adjacent screws, it should get messed up and blocked. So they will retract, it will turn, and then it will go back in position. And of course, being old military electronics, it is full of relays. So let's just do this. It will dial to the other frequency quite slowly, actually, making a lot of fun noises. So really, really quite fun, this thing. And also there is a number of relays in the radio. Really, I will go to the other one. Okay, really quite something. Another accessory I use for this radio is this big power amplifier box that I did already do a teardown of. Check the link down below. Okay, now I will prepare for the next parts. We'll have a walk around on these things. First, I will, excuse me, disconnect the power supply for my own safety, because I have here a super safe setup with fixing mode power supply and captain tape. So I prefer having this disconnected and out of the way for some reason. I am a little bit weird sometimes. Do not want to get electrocuted. So, this box, I will now disconnect this. I had to make my own cable for this, because I found the machine cable on eBay, but it was 10 meters long cable, and it was around 50 euros, I believe. I know don't need such long cable, and it was too expensive for just one 5 minute test of the thing. This is already undone. This can go out of the way. Okay, now I walk around on the device. Maybe if I can. Also, yes, I am very poor in BNC connections. Here I am using RCA to BNC converter to fake antenna with speaker wire. This is totally the kit, guys. Totally going to work. But it was just a quick test. Nothing serious here. About serious use of a thing. And I have no amateur radio license, by the way, anyways, but this is just a receiver, so no issue here. So first, this antenna tuner, it is actually my second unit I have. The other one is in much better paint condition, but is missing this vehicular mounting thing. Here I got it, at least, but it is also quite bad. It is just a box with two adjustments for the capacitor and coil, probably with a special tool I do not have, and just three connectors, one going to the radio, one BNC going to the radio, and the other one going to the antenna. Here is the information for you on this thing. So there are several manufacturers of this radio. The most common is Cell, Standard Electric Lawrence, I believe, a very well-known German electronics brand, but there is also some made by Telefunken, at least, and maybe some other companies Maybe Philips, I'm not sure, but Telefunken and Cell were really the biggest manufacturers of these devices for the NATO and German army in massive quantities. Really, they were made in insane quantities. Just think to the amount of money, raw materials, and time that were needed. It is where all the earth resources w went in the 70s during the Cold War. Really quite insane. Okay, I will get this out of the way. And now walk around about on this radio. So first we did see the control box here. I will zoom in a little bit better for you again. But we will have a look, detailed look at it when in the teardown part of it. On the side here, the two connectors actually to the audio equipment as a headset or handset or anything, speaker or anything else. So these connectors, in my case, were pretty bad, and actually I did replace them because the original ones, the rubber part in the middle, which is normally soft and will allow the contacts to retract when you connect the matching plug. It is designed with flat surfaces here and ball surfaces here with springs. The original plugs here were this rubber part was rock hard and actually falling in parts, in powder. So it was not possible at all to insert anymore the plug because the contacts here will not retract anymore and allow the latch to work correctly. But luckily enough, they are a common part, very lot used on military radios, and I was able to find a bunch of replacement ones, and it was not even necessary to unsolder wires because they are all made the same way. And it was possible to take apart the back piece of the connector and just swap the front part, while keeping the original back piece with the contacts soldered. They come, here they are. I will show you. So I have more parts here for them. So this one is a stock one I keep for repairs. This one, so I got them from eBay, a contact on eBay, 5 I believe for 15 euros. So it was not too bad because you can find them at very random prices also. And in fact, how it will work, you have a back part like this with your wired soldered, your wires, and you have these things that will fit into the I have no ear, into this spring-loaded contacts, and actually the springs are all here. So these ones will not work anymore because it is the one with decayed and rock hard rubber. But I was lucky to find a matching replacement part and be able to swap just the front piece. So there is a circlip and you have to press down with all the spring, but it is a little bit complicated, but I managed to do it and it was not too much work. So this is good. What else? So this front box, control box, is secured with big screws to the front here with red. So all the screws you have to undo are painted in red in this thing. So on the bottom here, excuse me, you have a pretty sturdy vehicular mounting plate made of a thick aluminium. You have this module with mainly signal distribution and a power supply unit. Here you can see the main power supply connector with just two contacts in it. Here is a pinout for you if you need it. So various cables to the antenna tuner, to the other vehicular distribution setup, because they are most of the time vehicular, these things. So big shock absorbers here, mounting bracket for the radio, some grounding strap with very serious bolts. Other side on the base, you have one fuse on one weird device here. Some pressure relief thing, I believe. Not sure what it is exactly. Quite weird. You have the main unit of the radio with screws on the top for mounting something else. It is a plate with a box. I am not sure exactly what it does, and it is quite hard to find this part. I would love to have one to put on the top, but I was not able to find one so far. Okay, now I will do the initial disassembly. I mean, taking apart the separating the modules of this radio. So the first thing you have to do is to disconnect the control box with this number 16 cable, like this. So super super strong cables. You can find them on eBay if you need one at various prices again. So this one is a little bit sad, but working at least. Another cable you have to undo is this big and very special one from the base plate to the radio module. So it is in two parts. The top part, you have one middle screw. And on the bottom part, you have two screws on each, one on each side, so you know what it means. It means you have to undo them evenly. If not, bad things will happen. You might break something or bend the contacts most commonly. So you have really to do them evenly. And I believe it is even written here in German. So super nice gold plated contacts here, and here one coax. Also for the antenna, obviously. And this is really something, this part, with its own NATO stock number, of course. Very, very sturdy. I believe we have, yes, steel wires on the side to reinforce this part. Really, really something quite impressive. Okay. Now, next easy step is to undo our control box, which is already by itself quite heavy, so you have to take care when you undo it, in particular the last screw. Okay, on this particular unit, stamps, well, stickers from the, excuse me, focus, from the German Army, here and here, again, the everything has its part number, and one other interesting sticker here, maybe the Army base or facility where it was serviced or something like this. And on the back here written ALU with mold number, maybe it is cast aluminium, this part. Okay, so this is off at least. Next step is to undo the two big springs here that are securing with this part the radio in the mounting here. So for this purpose, really, you have to be careful because the springs are strong and dangerous, believe me. Do not do them with your fingers. Bad thing could happen. By the way, this is a super vintage pair of pliers from my grandpa. It must be at least 50 years old, made by Peugeot Company. I had it forever. And it is still working well. Okay, this is undone. And now, with a big screwdriver, you can slide the radio part towards the front. And with some muscles, it will lift out. Okay, leaving here the base piece with a power supply and this particular mounting. So to remove this part on the top here, that is well, it is actually not completely necessary to service the power supply module because you have a cover here, but for the video purpose anyways, I will undo it. So on the front it is quite easy. You have two super big screws, flat head. Just find a screwdriver big enough, and it will come right off. 8 millimeters, one by Stanley here, diamond coated. But on the back, you have these pins things. With a spring for some reason, it is to latch the radio module in place, I believe. And you have an hexagonal head buried in here, with no reach. There is no enough gap to use a regular pipe wrench. It will not fit. So for this, the only tool you can use is actually this kind of pipe wrench made of thinner metal. So this is a Chinese set. They are quite hard to find actually. I got this one from Banggood, but I believe that it is not available anymore on Banggood. And you have to research pipe wrench set on eBay and try to find one from China, but really not easy to find. You do not need them every day, but when you need them, it is when you really need them. I will demonstrate it. So which side it is? It is totally not the correct one. Maybe this one. It is a little bit sad they did not write the size. It is a ship tools, so they did not include the information about the size. Here we are. It is barely fitting, but it will be good enough to allow unscrewing. If not, without this tool, I believe I would not have been able to unscrew these back parts. They were tight, and even with pliers or anything, it will not work. So it is when you have tools you use once in a while, but when you need them, really, you are happy to have them. Okay, so this is done. Now this part will just lift out. Ah, of course, if I undo here, the I believe it is, excuse me, 8 millimeters or 9, 10 even. The ground strap which side, this one, for instance. This is a pretty serious ground strap, by the way. I will reinstall this in order not to lose it. Okay, now this part is coming off. Of course, it's on sticker, but not on number, and it is called the Alteraman E. It has its own serial number. Okay, now the power supply is more accessible. And it can actually be separated from the base here with more big bolts. It would not be necessary for me. I did already. Maybe not actually. I see dust here, so maybe I will clean it again. There is dust. Look at this. But really, and there is here warning. I am not very fluent in German, but I believe it says you have to remove the power supply before opening this box, or something like this. Okay, so the modules are now all separated. So stay tuned for the other parts of this video with the teardown of the modules. So this will be quite easy, the control box will be quite easy. But the main unit here will be very tedious because there is a lot of plug-in modules that contains modules that are soldered, and to see their contents I will need to unsolder a bunch of wires and document it, of course, in order to be able to reinstall them correctly. By the way, do not take care of a mess here, and ta-da! This will be also a nice teardown, but quite tedious also. Okay, so thanks for watching for now. Bye bye.